Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to add sound effects in iMovie. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now, when you're creating videos in iMovie, you may want to add sound effects. Fortunately, iMovie has a built-in set of sound effects that you can use, but you can also use any sound effect that you get from another source. So let's start off with a simple iMovie project. I'm just going to drag a video in here of a beach, and it's got no sound. It's a silent video, so I definitely want to add some sound effects here in the background. Now, to get to the built-in sound effects library, all you need to do is go to Audio, and then look on the left here, and you should see Music, Sound Effects, and GarageBand. Music will show you songs that you have in your music library. GarageBand will show you things that you've created in GarageBand. Sound effects will show you these built-in sounds, and you have to go here and click here, and it gives you a list of all of the different things you have installed. So you should see sound effects, which are part of iMovie. They're actually built into the app. Also, iLife sound effects, which used to be part of iLife, that's iMovie, Photos, and GarageBand, but they're now built into iMovie as well. And you can see these various categories underneath them. You also see theme music that's part of iMovie. And you may or may not see Final Cut Pro sound effects. I see it because I have Final Cut Pro installed. But if you don't have it installed, you should see this last section here. Now, to search all of these, you can select the category effects at the top. And that gives you everything. I'm going to stick to just iLife sound effects so I see mostly what you see when you look in iMovie if you don't have Final Cut Pro. Now you can search here for a sound effect. So let's search for ocean, and you can see that there's one called Ocean Surf. It's in the section called Ambiance. If I want, I can preview the sound by clicking the play button here, and then drag and drop is just bring it here underneath. You could bring it on top, but it's going to actually snap to underneath here. So I can put this in there. Now I've got this video, instead of being silent, it has some sound to it. Now let's try something else. Let's try bringing in this video of a dog barking. Now in the case of this video, there's no sound. Or maybe you recorded this yourself and you do have sound, but the sound isn't very good. You hear all sorts of traffic and people are talking and things like that. So what you can do here is you can add your own dog bark sound. So go right to where the dog is starting to bark. So you position the playback head right there. Let's search for a bark right there. Listen to that. Great. Let's bring that in and stick it right here. So now we can play it. And we can see the first bark matches, but the others do not. That's okay because we can adjust things. Let's zoom in a little bit here by using this control. And we can create a mark wherever we hear the dog bark. I can do that using the M key. So there's the first bark. So I'm going to select the video clip there by clicking on it. I'm going to press M to leave a mark there. There's the second bark. And there was kind of the third bark right there. Bark, bark, bark. Okay. So now we can go and we can cut this up here by simply positioning the playback head there using Command B, just like we would with a video. It works with sound as well. So now we cut that. We can click here and cut this again. There. So now we do take three separate barks. I'm going to delete this fourth part here. And I'm going to move these around a little bit so that the barks happen at the right moment. We get this bark right here. This bark will get, so it's positioned right there. We can see when it starts. And then this one will position right here. A little bit over more. And we can take these dots here and actually fade out the bark a little quicker, since the dog's barking a little faster than what we currently have. So now let's listen. Great. And let's lower the volume of this last bark. We have the volume control right here, this line here. I'm going to drag that down to lower the volume there for that bark. So you can keep playing around with that till you get your sound effects right. Here's another example. Here's a car that's going to explode. It explodes right about there. So we can position the playhead there. Let's look for an explosion. Now, We don't find one. There isn't an explosion there. So let's look for something that's close. So under iLife sound effects here, I'm going to look for all the different things. And I can see there's one called booms. And we have a few things here. Here's some slamming metal. That sounds pretty close to an explosion, but not quite. But let's bring it in. And now if we play it, that's close, but let's make it a little bit better. I'm going to select it here and I'm going to slow it down a little bit. So I'm going to go to the speed control here. This is the same speed control you would use to slow down or speed up a video, but you can use it for sound as well. So I'm going to change it to slow here to slow it down. That already sounds better. I can also go here to effects, and there are clip filters for visual effects, but audio effects are right here. And if I select something like pitch down, I can hear a preview. So pitch down 2 is going to take it down 2 octaves. Like that. So I like how that sounds. And even though it's metal slamming, it works well enough as an explosion. Now what about bringing in your own sound effects? You don't have to use the ones that are here in audio. Here's a video of somebody opening a door, and it would be nice to have a sound associated with that. And I actually have an MP3 file of a sound effect that I downloaded online. You could find sound effects all over the internet. You'll find some sites where you can pay for sound effects. You can find other sites where you can get them for free. So whatever you get, whatever format it is, you can probably use it in iMovie. I'm going to drag this sound right in. So it's just an MP3 file, and I just drag it right to the timeline in there. You don't have to do any special tricks to import anything. And I'm going to bring it over here and try to match it up. So here's what we have so far. So it sounds right. I got to move it over a bit. It helps if you zoom in like that. So I could see exactly where the door should be opened right there and move over the sound effect. And you can keep playing around with it until you get the sound just right. Here's another example where we're going to overlay some sounds. So I have some seagulls at the seashore, and I'm going to look for ocean sounds again. Got to make sure you're in the right category. And there's ocean surf, so I'll bring that in. And let me have it come in right away instead of gradually coming in like that. And I'm going to lower the volume a bunch like this. So it's just some nice quiet ocean background sounds. And then I'm going to search here for gull. And there are seagulls. So let's bring that in as well. And I'll bring that over here. So this works really well. There are lots of other ways to modify these sounds to make them your own so they don't sound exactly like everybody else that's using the seagull sound built into iMovie. I've showed you where you could speed things up, and you can certainly do a slight speed up. So I can do custom, and instead of going to like 50% or 10% or something like that, I could just do something subtle like 90%. So now it sounds just a little bit different. You can preserve pitch, so instead of changing the pitch, it will actually try to keep the pitch even though the speed is different. If you click here, you get access to an equalizer. So you've got the ability to do various things here. So, for instance, let's do a treble boost to slightly change the sound. We could go to audio effects here as well. And we could try different things here. I'm going to use muffled here, change it a bit. You could also do interesting things like under speed, you can reverse a sound effect to try to make things a little bit different. And you can always use volume automations to change the volume at different points. To do that, you go to this line. Instead of dragging up and down to change the volume completely, you can option click and it creates points. You can create as many of these as you want, and then you could drag either the points or the space between points up and down to change the volume. So this can make things go up and down a little bit here and make the sound a little different. And then of course you could trim the ends of these here. I could grab the circle here at the end and have a fade out, both of these like that. And there are several other ways to get sound effects for iMovie besides finding them online. One way to do it right here in iMovie is to go to Window, Record VoiceOver. And this gives you recording controls right here. And you can use your microphone and record something. I got to position the playback head somewhere in here. But it doesn't matter exactly where because I can move it later. And then I can record my own voice. Hey. Then hit stop. And then you'll end up with this little voice over here. Hey. And if you can imitate sounds in nature, make your own explosion sounds, clap, make sounds using objects around the room, like Foley sound effects that they would make in the movies using real objects, then you could record them this way and then alter them as you like with all the techniques I showed to get them to sound right in your video. Or you can go out into the world and record these using your iPhone. Just use the Voice Memos app that's already on your iPhone. And then if you're using iCloud, it will sync with the Voice Memos on your Mac. And then to use these, all you need to do is drag these into the Finder. You can put them, say, in the desktop here. And once they're there, you can drag them into iMovie and have a sound recording from your iPhone very easily put into iMovie. So there you can see the basics of adding sound effects. It's pretty easy, but if you learn just a few more techniques, you can go a lot further with just a simple set of sound effects or things you record on your own. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.